least the gunfire means he's still alive. For now.
Is that a galleon?
Yeah, sure looks like it.
No escape. Let's just say I hope that's one title that's incorrect. At least we're getting out of the cave.
It's a ship graveyard. Looks like we can get down this way.
Yeah, it looks safe.
It's about as safe as anything on this island.
Starting to wonder if anybody got off this rock with all those ships down there.
We're getting closer to them. Sam.
He's surrounded.
Yeah. Come on. We gotta go get him. We gotta find a way to the beach.
Hey! They're behind you!
Ah, crap.
Lights and cover! Go!
Mind if I borrow the box? Sniper. Gotta grab him first. And... one special. Man, aim's off today, isn't it? Guy right up front. These things like they used to.
Seriously?
Get back.
Ah, oh, frack.
They are to take down. Now we're talking.
Oh,
This way!
Oh. I don't think I'm done with this thing yet. How long do you think we can hold on to this? Anything in here? Any targets? Definitely some targets. More big boys.
Find your brother.
Yeah. Okay.
Stock up. Ooh, the Mettler. Franks, we're good. More ammo for the Mettler. I'd rather have a better pistol than this, if anybody's got it.
Hey, come on. We can get
through. Not really. All right. Coming.
Okay, where did Sam go?
He went this way.
Well, there's your answer.
Down. Welcome. You know we're running low on ammo for this thing.
Man, you're a sight for sore eyes.
Yeah. How about we get off this damn beach, huh?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
you find my lighter?
We've got bigger problems than that.
Shit! We're sitting ducks in here!
We gotta take out that RPG!
The cliffs! We can take cover there!
Big guy, right. Sound too good.
That's our way across.
I don't have another rifle. Let me get armed here.
Right behind you guys.
Boarding party. My turn. crap.
How many of these trucks did you bring?
Wow. There's... not much cover here.
Frack.
Shoreline Merc had an RPG. What the hell is it? Okay. Aha! Gotcha! Thank you for the exit.
Man. I think it was easier storming Normandy. Got grenades, got a rifle. That was ridiculous.
Son of a bitch, another one?
Better in my head.
Nice work, kid.
Yeah, thanks for the assist.
Come on over. I'll get you out of there.
Please.
Good to see you, kid.
Right in the nick of time.
Yeah, well, got a little antsy waiting around to hear from you two.
No, we gotta find Sam and Elena still.
Hey.
Hey.
Are you okay?
Yeah.
We heard those explosions, we thought...
Yeah, that's all this guy.
You saved his ass again?
Naturally. How are you doing?
Good. Good. There were some close calls, but, he covered me.
Hey.
Hey. How's that?
Oh. Bullet grazed my shoulder.
Yeah.
You?
Cliffside grazed my face. So how'd you lose Rafe?
He led his crew right into one of Avery's traps.
Smart.
Hey, look. About the whole Alcazar thing.
Hey, just, we gotta save that for later, okay? Which way?
On the beach, other side of this town.
Okay.
Good, I hope all that ruckus didn't attract any attention.
Whoa. Sorry. What are we doing?
What do you think we're doing? We're getting the hell off of this rock.
Right, we could do that. Or we could head in that direction, which is a shortcut.
Shortcut to what?
To Avery's treasure.
Oh, wow.
I mean, Rafe's got to go all the way around, but we can
Rafe.
Hey, Victor, with all due respect, maybe just
leave this... You just don't know when to quit.
Look, we're all here for the same reason, right? Right?
We didn't come after the treasure. We came after you.
And I appreciate that. I do. But we're good. And we've got the lead for now. We can do this. Nathan, come on. Huh? Look around. Okay? Avery scuttled every last ship on this island. You know why?
Because he was hell-bent on keeping his treasure.
Exactly.
No matter the cost to the others around him.
Because he didn't want anyone to follow him. Because he was leaving. Look at this. I found his map of the island, okay? That's his ship right under that mountain. That's where our treasure is. And it is exactly where Rafe is headed right now while we stand around here and argue like idiots.
What if he's already left the island and his ship sunk somewhere out there in the middle of the ocean?
Then we find out where it got sunk.
Oh, boy.
How long have we been chasing this thing, huh? You and me. No offense to these guys, but they don't get it.
Actually, Sam, they do. They really do.
Okay.
Trust me, they've seen this kind of obsession before. Sam, we're not those kids anymore. We're not. And we got nothing to prove.
Victor, where's that plane?
Right this way.
Is it far?
Not very. Just through this port town.
What if Shoreline set up an ambush by the plane?
They didn't.
And what makes you so sure?
Because they're heading to the mountain. For the treasure.
I don't know, I still got a bad feeling about this. Somebody's obsessed with Sam.
There she is.
It's a long drop. How did you get here?
I hopped down a few of these walls, but I guess we'll have to find another way around.
Really on edge right now. These things are too calm.
I jumped down from up there, but it's too high to get back up.
Yeah, maybe there's something we can put under it?
Give me a hand, Sam.
All right.
Hey, you need a hand?
Hey, no thanks. We got it.
Anyone see a way out?
Nothing there.
Hey guys, through here.
Getting there.
I can't wait to sleep in my own bed again.
So close, yet so far.
Whoa, check that thing out.
It's like a sky rail or something.
Think it still works?
There's no controls, but I bet I could pull the platform with my rope.
Maybe if you could get to that wooden platform down there.
This seems like a bad idea.
I got an idea. Nathan, give me a hand.
Wooden platform.
Okay.
Victor, can I borrow you for a sec?
Sure.
All right, go ahead, Nathan. There, we'll hold it down, you jump across.
You're not gonna drop me, are you?
Tempting, but no.
Well, maybe.
Do I need to rope it first, though? Let me do this. No, I can't move when I do this. I guess maybe I'll do it after.
Made it!
Here we come.
Got it. All right, hop on. I'll pull you across.
Okay, we're ready.
Well, this is some impressive engineering for a bunch of pirates.
This is nothing. You should have seen the elevators.
You have elevators?
Whoa!
Hang on!
You guys all right?
Yeah. It's like a roller coaster.
Come on up, Nate. All right, Nathan, you climb on up. I'll grab you. Go! Jump off, quick!
Nate, Give me a hand.
Sam!
Bitch!
Sam, come on!
Huh? Hey.
Come on, just jump, I'll catch you. Let's go. No. No, no, don't you even think about it, you hear me?
I'm sorry I got you into this. All of you.
Hey, all that doesn't matter anymore, okay? Just jump.
Come on, Sam.
You gotta see this thing through, Nathan.
Sam, hey, listen to me. If you do this, I'm not coming after you. You hear me?
I'm sorry.
Sam! Sam! Oh,
stupid, stupid. You called your bluff?
He's gonna get himself killed. Come on.
She's probably right.
Of course she is. Let's go.
Up here. Maybe we can head him off.
I'm gonna save him, and then I'm gonna punch him.
All right, let's just worry about the saving part first.
What the hell is he thinking? I mean, after everything that we... Wasn't this enough? Let's just find him.
Getting a little carried away here, but once again, so much to look at. But yeah, I definitely feel that sense of urgency. Another one of these things.
Hey, we can get over that wall with this.
Come on!
Here, we got you.
You ready?
Almost there.
He's got it!
This isn't gonna hold.
Dang, go.
No, I got it.
Go.
God damn it. Now, how the hell are we supposed to get up there?
We don't have enough time.
Nate? No, not by yourself.
Look, I'll come right back, okay?
Look, he is not gonna leave without a fight.
Yeah, well, then I'll fight him if I have to, but either way, I'm bringing him back. Just get the plane as close to the mountain as you can and be ready for a quick getaway.
Like there's another kind?
It's not fair. Huh? Doing the dishes? We take turns? Don't even think about not coming back.
I love you.
Same to you, cowboy.
Brother's keeper. Things are getting heavy.
Okay.
What's that? Footprints.
Sam!
God damn it. I'm sure he's a ways off by now.
He's just obsessed. Just
gonna head to the creepy mountain, save Sam, get the hell out of here. Yeah. He's laughing about the whole thing tomorrow.
One would hope, but I don't know. He's as obsessed as those pirates.
On the trail. The footprints end here. Come on, which way did he go?
Gosh, look at that. Climbable there.
Footprints. Well, you didn't fall to your death, so that's good. Still get a chance to kill you.
This is just... Oh, man.
Jesus Christ.
Wish we could be enjoying it under different circumstances. Here.
Oh, it's Burns's grandson.
April 14, 1808. Although I successfully extracted Hayes's bullet from my thigh, the wound festers and the fever has not abated. I long to see what lies inside the mountain, but the pain is too great to bear and I must rest, regain my strength. With a moment's respite, doubt creeps into my mind. Was I wrong to punish the men for breaking their contract with me? I have dedicated my life to finding this place, finding Avery's treasure, and their actions nearly robbed me of my destiny. No, my actions were just. Tonight, I rest. The fever will break, and tomorrow, I finish my grandfather's journey. Then upon returning home, I shall write of my exploits here. A book by Jonathan Burns to sit in the libraries alongside history's greatest adventurers. At worst, I shall lose this leg, but in the end, I will have lived a life worth living. and Claire will be proud of me at long last. Claire, forgive me.
Close, but no cigar, pal. Almost at the finish line. Got the best of you. More footprints. Go.
Hey, Sam!
Not surprising.
There you are. Okay. Here we go. Whoa!
Great. More unreliability. Check where I'm going
here. Oh god, this is so much harder than it looks.
Down or continuing up? I think I'm running out of places to go. I mean, that doesn't go anywhere. I'm kind of confused. Let's see. There's something over there. Okay. Well, it looks like I'm doing that.
I can make it. I can do it. Oh, shit!
Time for another safety swing.
Crap!
made it. I don't know how I made it, but I made it.
My palms are liquid at this point. Straight down. Oh my.
Oh my god, that's Avery's ship.
All right.
This is crazy. It's just a straight jump.
Oh shit!
That was too close.
My way down.
Can't really see what I gotta jump onto.
Did you really do all that, Sam?
I doubt it. Probably found the dry way down. That's painful. Way down.
Yet another shiny.
Done here?
This is the last of them, ma'am.
Good. If we are, we can catch up with the others.
Sam just stole our goddamn boat.
He's headed for Avery's ship. Come on.
Let him. We're done.
We're done.
Most of my men are dead, Rafe. And those who aren't have already left.
Can you see that? The end is literally in sight.
That maniac pirate of yours has rigged this entire cave. I'm not setting foot on his ship.
Nadine, if you cut and run right now, the loss of all your men, everything that we've done, is for nothing.
We have millions in gold right here. I'd say that plus our lives is something.
No wonder so many of your men abandoned you.
Excuse me?
We're on the verge of making history here, and you're willing to just walk off with a pittance, a fraction of what Sam's gonna get from that boat.
If he can walk away from that ship alive, he can have it. Hell, I'd say he's earned it. God knows you didn't.
look, we can stand here and insult each other all day, or we can finish what it is that we've...
Oh, we're finishing it, all right.
Oh. Sorry, man. Thing about mercenaries, Nadine, their loyalty, it's bought. It's not earned. Now come on, either we can finish this thing together, or we can just end it right here.
Let's go make history.
Atta girl. By all means.
See what you have in store for us, Captain Avery.
Thief's End. No matter what, ladies and gentlemen, it has been an honor and a privilege. But hey, let's cheer up. We might run into the Goonies. Okay. How are we doing this? Is there anything for us to take a look at? Any resources here? What do I got? My 45? Are we just swimming across? Going from here.
Hey,
Look at that. There's your treasure. God damn. Was it worth it?
Nate?
Where is Sam?
Oh, he's right there.
Sam?
Relax, he's alive. Well, this idiot nearly got us all killed.
I'm getting him out of here.
No, you're not.
Rafe, you can have the treasure, all right? Just let me save my brother.
After everything he's done? How noble of you, but no.
We stay here any longer, and we're all dead. Is that what you want?
That's not what I said. What do you think, Nadine? Good to see you up and about. Be a dear and relieve Nate there of his gun.
Hand it over.
You really think you can trust him? Huh?
Not your concern.
Now, why are you trying to instigate? Nate? Nadine and I are our partners. I don't screw over my partners. Get over there. You and your brother, though. Right from the start, you took advantage of my generosity. You tried to cut me out, and it's high time you learn. What are you doing?
Now you give me your gun.
Nadine?
I won't ask you again.
You are being profoundly stupid right now.
Look over there.
Nadine, stop screwing around. Jesus!
I said look!
Okay, it's a couple of skeletons. So what?
I don't know as much about history as you boys, but I've got a pretty good idea who those two are.
Well, enlighten us.
It's Avery and Two. They killed each other.
Good for them. What's the point?
Everyone obsessed with his treasure gets what they deserve.
So what, you're just leaving us here to die?
Oh, I'm just leaving. Whether you die or not, I don't really care.
Nadine, wait.
So long, Rafe.
Nadine! Nadine! You open this goddamn door right now!
Rafe, she's gone! Come on, give me a hand, we'll all get out of here.
Won't work.
Come on, help me with Sam, and I'll help you open the door.
No, I'm not going to be able to enjoy one of these coins, knowing that you and your worthless brother are still sucking air.
Just calm down. You can practice your fencing when we get outside.
Nate, just shut up.
Seriously, Rafe, this is insane, even for you.
You want to hear insane? Nathan Drake raced a madman and his entire army to the steps of Shambhala.
Jesus!
Nathan Drake found the lost city in the middle of the Rub Al Khali Desert.
God damn it. Come on, we can get out of here together.
Nathan Drake discovered the fabled El Dorado.
Come on, Rafe, stop.
Nathan Drake is a legend. You know, I shot the man who told me that.
Look, I get it. You don't like me very much.
You know, for all your greatness, Nate, you have nothing. You are nothing. And I warned you to get out of my way. Sacrificed everything to find Avery, and I'm not gonna let a couple of stupid thieves, a senile con man, and a washed-up journalist take that away from me!
You care about that parade of losers so much. I'm going to make sure they join you.
On guard, dickhead.
That's the spirit. You know how to sword fight?
Yeah. Sticky with the sharp end, right?
Oh, this should be fun. Come on, Nate. Inevitable. My arm's getting tired. Dodge, parry. Come on. Now we're getting somewhere. I hear so much about. All right, all right.
We're done here. I'm taking my brother and we're leaving. If you want to stay and burn with the ship, you'd be my guest.
You got me. You know what, Nate? Underneath all the bravado, you're just a sad little boy with delusions of grandeur. Who, by the way, can't fence for shit. So long, Nathan Drake.
Nathan!
don't know when to give up. That's don't hand it to me. I had everything handed to me on a goddamn silver platter. I earned this. All of it.
You want the treasure, Rafe? It's all yours. Holy shit.
Say hello to Avery for me.
Hey, come on, let's get you out of here.
It's too heavy.
Let's try again.
It's no use.
Try again.
It's no use. Come on. Take this.
Damn it.
Listen to me. Listen to me. All I ever wanted to do was find this treasure with you.
Sam, hey,
shut we up. Did it. We did it, brother, okay? It's all right.
There's gonna be another way.
Nathan, you gotta go.
There's gonna be some.
You gotta go.
This tough. There is no other way.
Come on, Nathan. I gotta know you made it out all right.
No.
Nathan, the whole place is about to blow up.
That's it. That's it.
The hell you don't.
It's stressful.
Damn it.
Just get your head down.
She's one to know. Come on.
Got everything?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, feel free to sell anything I left behind.
Sure, I can't give you a lift home.
After the last few days, I think I'd like a plane with drink service and reclining seats. Plus, she and I have a lot to talk about.
Yeah, you do. And no more late night phone calls about one last time.
Promise. Thanks, Sully.
Take care, kid. Don't be a stranger.
Next time you're in town, beers are on me.
I'll hold you to that.
And then the bunny escapes anyway, and it leaves little bunny surprises all over the headmaster's bed.
Hey, what are you telling her?
Just about your little magic phase.
Oh, I hate you.
What was your stage name?
Go on, tell her.
Nate the Great. It's not funny. It makes sense.
In his defense, he was actually, you were pretty good.
Uh-huh.
Hey, look, Sam, it has been an experience getting to meet you.
With the handshake?
Well...
Bring it in for the real thing, sister. You take care of this numbskull, all right?
Yeah, I will.
I'll join you in a sec.
Yeah.
I like her. God help her, she sure seems to love you.
I know, right? Listen, the offer still stands.
I appreciate it, but I'm good.
I know, but if you feel like you're imposing, you're not. We talked about it.
It's not about that. It's a little bit of that, okay?
Yeah.
But I just kind of thought that after we found Avery's treasure, I'd be satisfied. Instead, I've kind of left with this strange feeling of...
emptiness.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you know, as thrilling as the next adventure might be, in the end, I always left with that same feeling. And sometimes you just gotta choose what you're gonna keep and what you're gonna let go.
Well, I guess I'm just not there yet. And besides, you know, you got a few ancient cities on me. I can't let that slide, so.
Yeah, I left a couple out there.
Well, thank you.
Oh, that's our ride.
Yeah.
Sam. Come far.
We sure have a little brother. Come here.
Listen, you don't do anything I wouldn't do, all right?
Get out of here, vemos.
Good night.
Yeah. So, Victor. What's next for you,
Well, before I got dragged into this, I was working on a business deal of sorts.
Of sorts? Dangerous?
Yeah. With these people, yeah. It's up there.
Well, I just so happen to know a certain someone recently out of prison who might be perfect for this kind of work.
Ooh, I don't know. Is he trustworthy?
More or less.
As is Portuguese.
Quando seu marido voltar para casa?
What's that mean?
How long before your husband gets home?
That'll do. Come on.
You got any more of those cigars?
Don't push your luck.
Good morning.
Indeed it is. Indeed it is.
All right, I'll bite. What's going on? Land a big contract or something?
Oh, even better. I'm on the verge of selling Jameson Marine.
No kidding?
Yeah.
Wow, well, hey, I guess congratulations are in order, huh?
Well, not yet, but I'm confident it'll go through. They drove a hard bargain, but in the end, I think we came to a mutually beneficial agreement.
That's great.
Yeah.
Are you gonna stay on?
No. I think I'd like to just relax, hang with the family, go fishing every chance I get.
Good for you. So who's the sap who's gonna buy this place?
Oh, you are.
What? No, come on, seriously.
Oh, yeah, seriously.
Wait, Jameson. Hey, wait up, man.
Hey. Morning, guys.
What are you doing here?
Just thought I'd take, you know, one final look.
Already gave your husband the keys.
Okay.
Perfect.
Is this for real?
Nate, all you need to know is that you'd be making a very wise investment. Do the right thing here. Call me when you're through.
You got it. Hi.
Hi. You're buying Jameson Marine?
We are buying Jameson Marine.
Huh. Okay. How? Why?
Well, heard this rumor about a salvage job off the coast of Malaysia, and I thought it'd be right up our alley.
No. Honey, look. We barely got out of Libertalia alive.
Yeah.
Hey, taking an illegal job? You know what that leads to.
Who said it was illegal? Look. This came in this morning.
Is this legit?
Yeah. Some of my old contacts out there, they worked their magic with the Malaysian permit office. It was great. I didn't even have to bribe anyone.
Well, that's good because I don't know how we could possibly even afford to do this.
Here. Hold out your hand.
What?
Hold out your hand. Come on.
Holy crap. Where did you get this?
It was in my jacket pocket. Along with a bunch more.
A bunch? Sam.
He's a sneaky one.
Yeah.
Of course, most of them are gonna have to go into our venture here. Along with all the new camera gear.
Camera gear?
Yeah. You know, I figured as we're pulling all the cargo up from the dive, we could hire, you know, a small crew. We could film the whole thing and resurrect my old show.
What happened to just living a normal life?
I think in our attempt to lead a normal life, we may have oversteered. Look. When I was on that island, I missed the adventure. I missed us. And so now we have a chance to do what we love. But from here on out, we are gonna operate on a strictly legal basis, all right? And I will be doing all of the shooting with my really expensive camera.
Wow. You've really thought all this through, haven't you?
More or less. But listen, just say the word and I will call the whole thing off.
What? Oh, no. I don't want to be that guy who ruins Jameson's early retirement like that. That'd be cruel.
Right.
It's not gonna be easy, you know.
Nothing worthwhile is. So, what do you say, Nathan Drake?
Sure, why not?
Hmm.
As long as I don't have to do any paperwork.
Well, I can't do it. I'm gonna have my hands full with the camera.
Well, I'm gonna have my hands full with all the diving.
Okay, fine. We'll take turns.
Yeah. Or I could play for it.
Seriously?
No, listen, I have been practicing. I'm getting good.
No.
My hand eye is way better than it used to be.
Really? I cannot do that to you again.
Are you afraid to play me?
I am so not afraid.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how scared are you to play me?
Like a 3.
Yeah, well, jack that up to like 11, all right? Because I'm coming for you.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, my. That's. Okay. Fine. You're on.
Oh, no. We did it.
Old school. I really should clean this up. Later. So good.
Oh, look, she's into climbing.
Mom? Dad? Anyone? Yoo-hoo!
You chill here. I've got some exploring to do.
I think they abandoned us. Oh, that looks beautiful. Sorry, Sully. Wow, Sam looks so young.
Not a bad life for a kid.
We should totally throw a party in here. They wouldn't even know. All right. But just this one. All right. But this is the last one for today. Okay?
Crying.
Here we go.
Dog hair all over my pillow.
Oh, cool. Sam and Sully are coming to visit.
We're sitting in a tiny cafe in the middle of a busy Havana street, drinking what might be the best goddamn espresso I've had in my life. No job, no one chasing us. Retirement is weird. Good, but weird. Sam says, tell him to stock up the fridge with less shitty beer before we arrive. His words, not mine. Sam is also reminding me that you lost the bet. To both of us, 12 months and counting with no smoking. And I'm in Cuba, for God's sake. That's how good I've been. Anyway, send the girls our love. Tell Cassidy to warm up the backgammon board. I want my rematch. Looking forward to seeing the gang in a couple of weeks. Your pal, Victor.
Look at these two.
We'll be going out there. Tad wasteful. So that's her room.
Well, so cool. I need to ask Mom to borrow this one again.
Oh, sorry, guys. Not in the mood for any copyright strikes today. I think we've seen everything in here. Well, minus this bathroom, right? Every nook and cranny.
Off she goes. Taj Mahal, here I come. Just a few more weeks. Day. Now all we need is the rest of our boat crew. Well, the car's here. Maybe they were abducted by interdimensional beings. Or maybe they just walked to the store. anyone? No? Nothing? Okay. Hey, Vicky. Okay, girl. Where's Mom and Dad? All right, go find them. Go! Really? Fine, I'll find them myself. the food's all here. And not here either. Okay, I guess I'll just wait then. Whoa. Good job cleaning this up. You figured it out.
Looks like they're still discovering things. Sunken statues recovered. Archaeology. Now look at those, some of the treasures we found while playing. DNF Fortunes does it again.
Oh, yeah, I was hanging out with Soli for this one.
Adventuring duo, DNF Fortunes leads expedition into Cambodia.
Oh, this was definitely my favorite dig. I remember that one. Look at you all bright-eyed and bushy-tailed.
Good old Sully.
What do you keep in here? So goofy. He left his keys. He left his keys! There's no way. There's just no way. Whoa. I knew it. Oh, nice, gun holster, Dad. What is this?
We've seen all these things before.
A Spanish doubloon. But from where? Pirate coin. Kinda looks like Avery's sigil. Wait, is it Avery's sigil? Is that a bullet hole?
A little bit. I think that's Nate's Shema from Uncharted 3.
I don't know, some kind of resin or something? Weird.
Music from the classics again.
Kind of creepy. Kind of cool.
This is.
Whoa. Henry Avery. The Gunsway heist. Wait, did you go looking for Avery's treasure?
A little bit.
Parvus Magna. Greatness from small beginnings. What's this?
Found this on my old camera. Thought you'd like to have it.
What the hell? Oh shit. Crap.
Hey, there you are.
Hey.
Been looking for you. What are you doing in here?
Looking for you guys.
Come on, we loaded up the boat. It's ready.
Cool. I'll catch up with you guys in a sec.
Why?
I just need to,
What's up, Cassie?
Okay. Don't be mad. I said, don't be mad.
Keys. So, what did you see?
Nothing really. Well, just that photo of you two and Sully. With a bunch of Spanish-looking treasure. And a shotgun. Yeah. Huh.
This is bound to happen sometime. Maybe we should just tell her.
She's not ready for it.
Ready for what? All that crazy shit in there?
Language.
Yeah, language.
Sorry. But you guys are literally keeping skeletons in your closet. Or at least a silver skull of some kind.
No, I don't think I'm ready for this. Really.
Nate, it's time to have the talk.
Yeah, it's totally time. Wait, which talk are we talking about here?
She's just a kid.
She's older than you and Sam when you started all of that.
That is different, and you know it.
Okay, look, if you guys were into some shady stuff, it's totally cool. But I think I'm old enough to know about it, right?
Old enough? How old are you again?
Funny. Mom?
All right.
Well, let's see. For me, it started when this guy called me up with a scoop on a massive historical find. It sounded like a complete fraud.
Yeah, handsome fraud.
No, I hadn't even met him yet.
She knew. She knew.
So this fraud says, if you fund the trip, then I'll give you the coffin of Sir Francis Drake.
And for the record, I totally delivered.
Yeah, you delivered us into the hands of Indonesian pirates.
No, come on, you know I had nothing to do
okay,
with that.
Guys, time out. You're saying that you were attacked by pirates after you found the coffin of Sir Francis Drake. Is that right?
Yeah, that's pretty much right.
Bullshit.
Language.
Crap.
Better.
All right, so keep going.
You know what? The sun is up, boat's ready, wind is just right. You want to continue the story? I say we do it on the water. Come on.
Well, wait, what did Francis Drake look like? Was it gross?
Actually, he wasn't in there. Yeah, just his journal with a map to El Dorado.
The city of gold?
That's the legend. Turns out it was just a statue, a cursed statue.
No way, seriously?
Yeah, seriously. But I'll get back to that.
Ladies and gentlemen, wow, Uncharted 4, A Thief's End, and what a beautiful ending it was. So much emotion throughout this entire title. If you're to ask me what my favorite game of all time is, it's this one. It's absolutely hands down this one. I mean, they knocked it out of the park each and every chapter. And when you thought it was going to die down at some point in terms of quality, it didn't. And even if you didn't play the original titles, you became attached to these characters and this story. And you know, I've always said that the Uncharted games are cinematic adventures, and that if you can't play them, you should watch somebody play them. And I'm glad that I could share this experience with all of you. And I really appreciate that, you know, at least a few thousand of you have joined me on this adventure. I have watched every single video that I've put out. And this is the first time I've actually ever completed a Let's Play series on the channel. The channel was never really designed to be a Let's Play channel, but I thoroughly enjoyed bringing you this. I didn't know that I was going to cover it. I thought I might just play it in the privacy of my own home, but I knew that I would most likely regret not sharing it. I had a gut feeling that it would be great, and it's just in my nature to want to share experiences. And it truly does mean a lot to me that you guys have, you know, sat through hours of this content, and it seems like many of you appreciate the way I tried to deliver it. For me, the game is the hero, and I'm along for the ride. It sells itself, obviously. You know, I try not to talk over the dialogue. I try to just play and to the best of my ability. Obviously, I'm not always great at the game. I'm not a puzzle master. And I get upset when I die because I feel like it ruins the cinematic moment. But hey, it's a video game. It does have its challenge. This is something that I'm still going to obviously have to process. There's just so much to talk about. I mean, that ending. I thought for sure Sam's number was up. You know, even midway through the game, I figured, okay, they're setting this guy up. He's the older brother. He's getting Nate into trouble. We found out about the Alcazar lie. I thought he would save Nate at the end. That the title A Thief's End might have been his end in a way. That he would say, you know, I got you into this. I'm going to get you out of this. And you know, jump in front of a bullet or save Nate's life. Sacrifice himself for Nate in some way. I really thought that was going to happen. And I probably would have been okay if it did. But I still would have been bummed out because, in spite of Sam's flaws, I think we still kind of grew to love him. With that said, it's so nice to have a video game present you with a happy ending for once. In this day and age, we're surrounded by negativity, not only in our real lives, but in our fictional ones. For me, video games have always been an escape from our harsh reality. You know, you come home from a hard day of work or school or whatever drama surrounds you in life. You want to play these video games and escape that and live vicariously through these characters and enjoy yourself. And, you know, I'm 35. When I grew up in the 80s and the 90s, a lot of movies and TV shows had happier endings where the heroes come out on top and the villains get what they deserve. And this was kind of a throwback to that. And I think we need more of this. I think it's okay that all the good guys survived, you know? There's nothing wrong with that. You don't have to kill off all the characters or even one character and create drama or negativity. It doesn't make things better. So this was really satisfying and not only at the end, but just the entire journey. Everything about this title, from the visuals to the storytelling and the acting, just it was all there. You know, the gameplay mixed in with beautiful scenery, brilliant compositions, you know, something that we might only see in movies. Cinematography at its finest here. Every scene was set up to look absolutely gorgeous. You know, you'd climb up over a mountain or a hill or on a building and you'd just be presented with this amazing vista, incredible detail, you know. And I tried to use the analog sticks on my gamepad to set up shots when I could to present you with a more cinematic gameplay experience. And you know, that's why I would be upset when I died, because I feel like it would ruin that. So I tried really hard not to die, but yeah, it just happens from time to time. I don't know, like, if I could complain about something. I mean, maybe the sword fight at the end with Rafe. I'm not a huge fan of overdoing QuickTime events. We had a lot of fighting in the game that was very natural. Like, we're fighting Shoreline hand-to-hand a lot doing the stealth combat and just getting into fights with them. And a lot of that was just natural, like punch, 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 counter, punch, counter, you know, things like that, roll away. I almost think the Wraith fight could have been more natural, like some of the other fights, except maybe with swords. You know, maybe it could have been on the deck of the ship with things falling over and exploding and you're dodging things and you're fighting him. I don't know, maybe it could have been more like that, but still at the end of the day, that was an intense fight that I'm pretty sure I almost died on because my entire screen was black and white. But you kind of just had to keep backing off and then and telegraph Wraith and then go for those blocks, which my hands were just freaking soaked. I mean, in sweat. It was just rough. And you're thinking, please don't blow this because you're going to ruin the movie. And it's a video game and you're still thinking that. But, oh man. And just, I don't know, just everything about it, the journey, traveling and seeing all these exotic locations, it made you want to do more with your life. It makes you want to go out and travel. And I've been to a few places. I've been overseas and I've seen quite a few things, but now I just want to do more. You know, I want to go on adventures myself. Legal ones. But gosh, I'm going to miss this. I really am. I loved bringing you this footage. It's bittersweet for sure. But it was nice to see Nathan and Elena, you know, getting on with their lives, but kind of maintaining adventure and having a daughter and getting to play as Cassie at the end was a nice treat. That was really cool how they did that. You got to kind of revisit the old Uncharted treasures and things again. And it was just very, very touching. Very much hitting you in the feels there and throughout the game. So many moments that I could look back at. The Jeep scene with Elena and Nathan when it got very quiet and it was just music playing. Oh man, that one hit me hard. Variety of moments in this game kind of hitting close to home. It's been an interesting year for me, which is why I very much appreciate you guys watching my stuff. It means a lot, it really does. But this game is not one that I am soon to forget. I'm glad that I was able to experience it, and I'm glad that, again, I was able to bring it to you in this fashion, and I really hope that you got as much out of it as I did. I believe there is talk of DLC for this game. I don't know what it's going to be. Considering the ending that we just saw, maybe something with Sam and Sully when they were at the docks talking about getting into some trouble. Who knows? That would actually be kind of cool. Sully's always been one of my favorite characters, so I wouldn't mind playing as him or something. But if that's the case, I'll try to bring that to you as well. But, wow. I guess we're done here. Sadly, I almost wish I could undergo a mind wipe and experience it anew. But, everybody in these credits, you know, they deserve more attention than they'll ever get. This was a work of art, and you could see the blood, sweat, and tears that went into this. Passion at its finest. I'm sure there's things that we could look at and critique and nitpick and whatever, but come on. I mean, let's be fair here. This was just absolutely an amazing experience. But special thanks to Naughty Dog, even though you're probably not listening. Thank you for this. This is an experience of a lifetime. It was more than a video game to me. And of course, again, thank you to all of you for sticking around and watching this. It really does mean the world to me that you watch stuff that I share on the internet. So maybe there's room for some more Let's Plays on the SideStrafe channel. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, Sig Parvus Magna, and I'll see you on the next one.